Okay, John Boat update. I went to Home Depot and I got the ply board and had them cut it. And then I brought it back and I put notches in it. The notches are an inch and a half in and an inch and a quarter wide. I also got them to cut some of these boards, and I'm going to, when I waterproof these boards, I'm going to waterproof those on the back side of these and so that it's got a little support. And we're going to use this, since this bed armor done so well, we're going to waterproof those plyboard with bed armor. And we'll see how long they last. We also got carpet to go over it. So once we, I've got three more cans of that. And I also need to touch up where I took some, that bracket off there. And so anyway, we're getting ready to put a, bilge pump in. Oh, back here, when I cut my board, I cut out for the bilge plug. And also cut out for the bilge pump. And so what we're going to do is we're going to drill a hole. We're going to drill a hole in the side of the boat. And we're going to put in this bilge pump. So we're going to take a drill bit that's basically half the size. It's basically the size of the nipple portion here on this through the hole fitting. And then we're going to do the rest of it with a Dremel. So we're going to take... So then we took a marker and we put the gasket here and we traced the inside diameter of the gasket. Then we took the Dremel and went all the way around in a circle just like that. Let's see if we're the size I want. What I want is I want to be able to screw the threads through here. I think we're just a little off. Just got to do a little bit more. Just trace that line till you don't see any more marker. Now we're also going to put sealant on this. So let's see if it'll start. I think we're there. There we go. Look, if you do it a little bit at a time and keep trying it, what we've done is, I think I might get, there's a black one of these through the hull fittings that's a little bit shorter. I think I might go ahead and order that one. It's like $6 on Amazon or eBay, I don't remember. All right, so there's our fitting. Now, you got to make sure you're below this lip with the nut, because you don't want to overlap it, otherwise you're not going to get a good seal. So you have to try it. Make sure your hole, you still have to seal it yet with some sealant. I'm sure it'll be watertight, but I still want to put some sealant on it. So when you screw it down, you got to make sure that you clear this piece of metal so that you're flat up against the hull. And we clear it by, a millimeter or so. There we go. There's our through the hull fitting. Now, this bilge pump came with that hose there. Let me tell you about that hose. This is a corrugated hose, and not only will it slow the water flow down because it's got all these ridges in it, let me show you what happens with these hoses. They have a seam on them. Let's see if I can find the seam. They have a seam, which is where they were put together, and if you take it, see what'll happen? See that? This stuff is so thin, you can actually tear it. See that? So if you put it in there, and you're bringing stuff in and out, or you might step on it, what can happen is this can break on you. So I don't use that type of hose. I went and got some 3/4-inch hose. Here's the hose I got. And what we're going to do is, first we have to make sure it doesn't have too much stress on it. All right, so there's what we're going to do. Uh-oh, I'm stuck on a prop. There's what we're going to do. Now, once we seal that board and carpet, I'm not sure I'm going to carpet the back one or not. Once we seal it, I've got two brackets, hose brackets. One's going to go here. Someone had already had holes drilled for something, but the brackets very well could match up with those holes. We'll see. So that's a quick, easy way. Now, I've worked on a lot of boats, especially with my dad in the past, and I remember we did one with a hole saw, and the edge of the hole saw was just a little bit bigger than your through the hole fitting. So I didn't like that. It didn't leak, but he had to put a lot of sealant on it to make sure that it didn't leak. If you're doing it with for a live well or something like that, you want to make sure you're as tight as you can. And so on this aluminum, you can actually take that Dremel and make it the size, and it'll actually screw on. So it did really well. So on the front light, we're going to use these two. We're going to take it out of this mount. We're going to take that and cut it, and then we're going to use these two pieces of aluminum, and we're going to make a little channel, and that's where we're going to put the light. So that's the type of attachment that I used on that Dremel. It's not, you know, it's just a little sanding wheel that you slide down over the rubber piece. So if you go, I have a variable speed Dremel where you can adjust the speed. If you start out slow, you can just start grinding this a little bit at a time till you get to the point where your through the hole fitting will screw in. But we're going to go ahead and take the ply board up, and we're going to go ahead and coat it front and back, sides and everything, with the Dupli-Color bed armor like I done the inside. And so I really liked how it did here, and I put water across it the other day, and it rolled right across. So I think it'll work for me. I'm not going to take it out but 3 or 4 times a year probably, and it's going to be kept indoors anyway. So that being said, we're going to take the board out. I'm going to lightly sand the edges so it's not so sharp. Just bevel the edges so when I put the carpet on it isn't so sharp. And we're going to paint those up after I sand them. Let them dry really good. Then we're going to put the carpet on, put them back in. We're going to put this box. I'm pretty sure I sat in it. I think I'm going to like it. I put this box here, and it's going to hold the battery. I'll probably scoot it to one end or turn it sideways. It's going to hold the battery and maybe a tackle box and some other gear. But it also, it's pretty sturdy on top and becomes another bench. So I'm going to secure it down. I'm going to put some lag bolts through the bottom of this board before I put it in. So on these boards, I've actually just lightly took the sander and lightly beveled the edge, because I found that I've done this once before and didn't bevel the edge, and I found over time the sharp corner wears through the edge of the carpet. So we're going to bevel the edge a little bit more, and then we're going to coat it with that bed armor. That bed armor really coats nicely. I went all the way around the edge, and you got to keep shaking the thing every minute or so, or it'll come out and little splats, but even the splats level out. So I think it's going to do pretty well. It's taking to that board better than it did that metal. So let's get this one done, we'll get the others done, and maybe about 2 days we'll go ahead and put the carpet on and put everything in so we can get this thing on the water here next weekend or weekend after next. We'll see. Anyway, as much as I did, I should have got the two quarts rather than the spray. Like I said, I've never used this Dupli-Color bed armor. I didn't even know they had any bed armor other than black, but they got all kinds of colors. In fact, there's even brush-on bed armor in beige. I haven't used it, so this is going to be the first time. It says it's waterproof, so we'll see. You know, we'll see. So anyway, I know somebody's going to say, oh, I wouldn't use that bed armor. I wouldn't have done that. I would have got some marine ply board and put some sealer on it and everything. And well, people are going to do what they want to do. It's just another option out there. I'm up in the mountains of Appalachia, and there isn't a marine store within 250 miles. So I'm not getting a piece of marine ply board anytime soon. So this is another option. Basic ply board, sand it down, coat it with that bed armor, throw it in here. I might not even put the carpet on, we'll see. I'll probably put it on so when little Miss Muffet goes, she can have carpet on her feet. Anyway, it's a John boat. That big boat, that's going to be a different story. If I get into that big boat, it's going to be a little different story. So, but, and then I got the boat over there, the Sunbird boat. So, even that one is a different story. This John boat isn't going to go out much. That boat there will probably go out more than anything, unless I sell it. Anyway, I think it'll be fine. That it's been 2 weeks since I've done the bed armor on that ply board underneath the seats, and I've walked on it, I've stepped on it, I set the anchor on it, and poured water on it. You know, I'm kind of liking it. It's not bad. It's pretty sturdy stuff. I think I might use that on some things around the farm. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and make the brackets for the light here. Okay, I took this little bow light, and I took the Dremel with this little cutter wheel on it, and I cut it all good, about 6.5 inches off, and pulled the wire out of the bottom piece, just pulled it with a pair of pliers from the bottom there, and so I got a little lead, and I have some of this rubber that I'm going to put up in here to protect the wires. And then we're going to make this little bracket. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut notches in this and bend these out on both sides so I can mount that to the bow of the boat. And then this is going to get, I got to trim just a little bit because I want it to be tight. Okay, so what I've done is I pop riveted the top of the bracket, and I cut a notch and bent them back. So that's how that's going to sit behind that front of that rail. And then I got some rubber, and I'm going to drill through that and put a pop rivet into this bar. So it should hold it pretty nice. So on the bottom, what I've done is I've rolled some rubber. I had some rubber gasket, and I rolled two strips together and shoved them up in there so that wire will never have a problem. It's well cushioned, it's not going to fray. And I'm going to put some sealant in there and we should be good to go. Okay, so it's finished. I had some rubber material that I cut some and wrapped around before I pop riveted through the sides. So it's got two pop rivets to the back, two in the sides, and then I got my bracket. So it should sit basically like that. Well, my boards did really well. All right, so there's what it's gonna look like. I just gotta drill the holes and put the pop rivets in. Gonna be one there, one in there, and one in there. And then that'll be right on the front, just like that. I think it's gonna be perfect. Is good. I had that camera in my mouth. So my boards are, and those are my little cross boards there. My little stringer boards. I think they're going to do really well. That rubber coating is unbelievable. I really like that stuff. I think I'm going to use it for all kinds of things. There it is. What I did was I drilled two holes that goes through the rail bracket and into the boat, and I drilled two holes to go through the front of the boat. So it's not gonna rattle and it's not going anywhere. So there we go.